Listen up, your Bitcoin full node and all of the Bitcoin on it may very well be at risk. Here are 11 steps that you must take to protect your Bitcoin if you run a full node. First off, never put your entire stack on your node. A Bitcoin full node or Bitcoin Lightning node is by definition a hot wallet, meaning it is always connected to the internet. And unfortunately, as of right now, there is no easy way to run it as a multi-sig wallet, which would at least protect you against other people spending your funds. My recommendation, keep the majority of your Bitcoin on a cold wallet, such as a Trezor or other hardware wallet, and only put as much Bitcoin as you can reasonably afford to lose on your node. I know, it's super tempting to put your entire stack on the Lightning Network so you can increase your Lightning node routing and ranking, but it's just not worth it, at least until Lightning Network matures a little more and has more security features like multi-sig. Route all traffic through Tor. Okay, this is going to be a little bit controversial because there are many people out there who believe that Tor nodes are less effective at routing than ClearNet nodes. But here, I believe the jury is still out on that one. So here it goes. In the early days of Umbral and other routing node softwares, there was no way to disable the onion routing for all or any of the traffic. And that's a good thing. Tor gives you privacy and a certain level of security by obscurity, by hiding your node from would-be attackers. Nowadays, there are more and more ways to disable Tor or route traffic around it onto the clear web, but this should be avoided. Using Tor is one of the best ways to hide your node's location, both in cyberspace and in the physical world. So once you have all your traffic routed through Tor, make sure that you guard the address of various apps like your Umbral dashboard, ThunderHub, and so on. If you leak those out, you've defeated the purpose of routing traffic through Tor. Which leads me to my next point. Store your node locally on a network that you control. Ideally, not in the cloud. It might be tempting to run your node on the faster internet at the office or to use convenient cloud services such as Voltage.cloud to spool up an enterprise-grade node, but I recommend avoiding doing these things unless you absolutely have to. For example, if you are a business owner who needs an entrepreneurship enterprise-grade Lightning node with 100% uptime, etc. And even then, there are ways that you can run that hardware locally if you're focused on security. Basically, because we're routing all traffic on our node through Tor, the only way for someone to find and access it, short of you revealing your Tor address, is to find it on your local network, which isn't really hard at all because it'll be easily found on umbral.local, citadel.local, or whatever. Now, this means that a smart person on your network could potentially find your node, and while they probably won't be able to guess the password, there's nothing stopping them from trying and trying and trying to brute force it. In short, it's a good idea to put your Bitcoin node on a network that only people you trust are going to be using, which is actually a great segue into my next point. Secure your home Wi-Fi network. One of the things that I love about Bitcoin is that it forces you to always be thinking and asking yourself, now what is the weakest link in my security? So once you've put your node on a network that strangers don't use, it's time to actually secure that network. Now, I don't know about you, but I often see Wi-Fi networks that are secured by the outdated and insecure WEP standard, or even not secured at all. Most people don't realize it, but WEP security can actually be cracked in minutes. So if you're running something valuable on your home network, a Bitcoin node or security cameras, for example, then you need to make sure that you at least use WPA2 or even WPA3 security. Now, just as with your node password, this password should not be an easy one, though there's probably no need to auto-generate a long string of characters. You also don't want the password to be 0 to 9 either. Additionally, make sure that you safeguard the Ethernet ports in your wall and don't give your Wi-Fi password out to just anyone who asks, especially if they are not people you trust. Choose a secure location for your node. Now, we may have mitigated most of the risk of cyber attacks against your Bitcoin node, but many people overlook the most glaring attack vector of all, physical theft. In fact, most people don't realize it, but it's actually pretty easy to steal your Bitcoin off of your full node if someone gains physical access to it. In fact, Aaron Dews, the creator of Citadel and a major contributor to Umbral, has even created a tool that you can use to hack back into your node if you lose access. All you need is physical access and some time. And as Bitcoin becomes more and more recognized, you're going to see that home burglars are going to start looking for things like hardware wallets or full nodes just as much, if not more, than they look for cash and jewelry. So while I love all the cool node cases made by folks like CryptoCloaks, and I appreciate that people are proud of their nodes, you won't see me displaying my Bitcoin node prominently on my desk. Instead, I personally have my Bitcoin node hidden somewhere that you would never think to look, behind a locked door. Electrical closets in your walls are a great thing for this, and you can even install a lock on them for extra security. It's not a bad idea to put your node in a locking desk drawer or lock the door to your home office when you leave town either. Use a secure password and a password manager. Now, I alluded to this one before. It might be tempting to set the password to your node to something easy to remember and convenient, such as the street you grew up on and the year you were born, but don't do it. If your password is easy enough to remember, it's even easier to crack. I actually once was able to crack an old Bitcoin wallet that I'd created before I knew about password best practices in about 1 hour of work with an open source brute forcing tool. Now, I recommend using a secure password manager to both generate and store your passwords. I like 1Password, Bitwarden, or just the built-in password manager on your product is even good, as long as any synchronization that is done is encrypted on the cloud. A good password should have a random variety of numbers, symbols, and letters, both uppercase and lowercase. The longer, the better. Enable 2FA or two-factor authentication. A good password and hiding your node will take you far, but let's face it, sometimes people are able to crack passwords with things like keyboard loggers, cameras, hacking into your iCloud or LastPass, and all kinds of other schemes. For this reason, it's important to secure anything of value with a randomly generated two-factor authentication or OTP. This includes your bank accounts, exchange accounts, and of course, your node. One thing about 2FA, never use your email or SMS for 2FA because oftentimes a hacker will start by hacking your email, swapping your SIM, etc. Instead, it's better to use apps like Google Authenticator, Authy, or OTP Auth to get randomly generated OTPs. And of course, make sure all devices that have those OTP generators on them are secured with a PIN code and/or biometrics. Back up your keys in a secure way. I can't stress this one enough. Make sure that you have the seed phrase to your Bitcoin full node, those 24 words that you were given when you set it up, written down. To protect yourself against fire or flood, I recommend writing them down on a steel tablet, such as the Keystone tablet that I previously reviewed. A fire and waterproof safe is also a great idea. Now, keep in mind that if someone discovers these 24 words, they have control of your entire Bitcoin node. So don't just throw it in a desk drawer, and definitely don't put it on your Google Drive or Evernote. You can do all the cybersecurity in the world, but the fact is, your 24-word seed phrase is the easiest and most likely way that someone is going to steal the Bitcoin on your full node. Practice good OPSEC. Don't talk about it. Now, here's another one that I find really important, albeit one that I personally don't practice nearly well enough as a YouTuber. Practice good OPSEC, or operational security. Don't go to Bitcoin events and brag about your full node or where you store it. Don't advertise on Bitcoin Twitter how much you have in girth. When orange pilling the gardener, the electrician, or your girlfriend's best friend's brother, don't show them your node or where you keep it or how you access it. In other words, be as vague about your node and your Bitcoin as possible, unless you completely trust the person you're talking to. In fact, on that note, don't create unnecessary security holes for convenience, such as mobile access, etc. If you're as obsessed with your Bitcoin full node as I am, you're probably tempted to check it at least a couple times a day and see how much you're routing, what new channels have been opened, and so on. Now, this has led a lot of people to install things like Zeus LN on their phone, fully noded, or just the balance of Satoshi's Telegram bot, or just bookmarking the Tor address on their phone's Tor browser so they can log into ThunderHub from their phone. Look, I get it. I love checking my node too. But creating additional ways to access your node remotely opens up serious security holes. If your phone is stolen, especially if it's stolen right out of your hand while you're using it, someone can easily access these apps as well as your saved passwords and thereby access your Bitcoin. If you just can't resist the temptation to have this type of access on your phone, there are a few things that you can still do to mitigate some of that risk. Set up Find My Phone or equivalent on your phone so that you can wipe it remotely and immediately from another device if it's stolen. Require biometrics to open any Bitcoin or security related app, such as your OTP or password manager. Use a duress pin on apps like Zeus, which will erase your node if entered. And set limits on what the remote app can do. For example, only allow balance of Satoshis, Telegram bot to pay invoices up to 10,000 Satoshis. Where possible, use watch-only wallets to prevent someone from exporting your private keys from something like Blue Wallet. Now, if you, like me, need to have a specific app like BTC Pay visible on the clear web for your business, then use a reverse proxy for that app alone, rather than opening up ports on your router. Which is a good segue into our last point. Be careful what apps you install and what level of access those apps have. In theory, every app you install on your node should be vetted by the folks at Umbral, MyNode, Citadel, Raspbi Blitz, or whatever, and therefore secure. But as these platforms grow and more apps are added with less and less of a gatekeeper, it's just not possible to ensure that all of this is true. For this reason, you should be very careful what you install on your node, especially if you're installing something directly from a GitHub repo through the command line instead of through the App Store. What's more, when setting up these apps, just as with the balance of Satoshi's Telegram bot, try as much as you can to limit access where possible to only the features necessary. This is easy to do with something called Macaroons, a Lightning feature that actually lets you create access keys for only certain functionality, as well as through the use of watch-only wallets for things like BTC Pay. So there you have it, my list of 11 top tips to secure your Bitcoin full node or Lightning node. Did I miss any? Do you agree or disagree with any of these? Well, let me know in the comments below. I hope you guys have really enjoyed this video. If you have, please take a moment to smash that subscribe button and the bell icon and give me a like so that others on YouTube will see this video as well. I'll see you guys soon. Take care.